Hey guys, Ryan from Liberty. Today we're going to be shooting the CZ P10C, which is one of CZ's brand new guns. Really neat firearm, it's striker fired. As of making this video, these guns are rather hard to get, so this is the first one we've been able to handle. First one that came in the shop too, and Brian Hogan from Long Hollow Hydrographics purchased it and has been nice enough to let us borrow it to shoot a video today. So before we do anything, I want to get a big shout out to Brian at Long Hollow Hydrographics for letting us borrow this gun and shoot it. And you know, he does a great job with Hydrographics. They do Cerakote too. Really impressive work. So if you haven't ever been to Long Hollow Hydrographics Facebook page and checked out his work, you can link to it from the Liberty Sport and Pawn webpage. Make sure you go there and check it out. And we actually have one of his guns that he Cerakoted, and a Ruger LC9S. So you can see, you know, great Cerakote job on this gun. This is somebody's everyday carry. So, you know, really, really good job, and light colors like this are kind of hard to get right too. But he does a great job. Anything you want to get done, he'll be able to do it. And he does a few other things besides firearms too. So if there's something that's not a firearm, you want to get a hydro dipped or Cerakoted, give him a call and see what he can do for you. Anyway, back to the gun. So the CZ P10. This is a compact firearm. It comes with a 15 round magazine, striker fired. Has one of the best triggers of a striker fire gun that we've seen come out yet. The pull on this is really light. It's not very long, really smooth. And the reset is fantastic. The only thing I can really compare it to would be the Sig Legion series on the reset. So that's you know, that's a lot of credit to CZ for making a really good trigger in this gun. The one thing I don't like in the trigger is this trigger safety. It does tend to drag when you're trying to squeeze the trigger for that first little bit right there, and that's kind of annoying, but there's some things we can do to fix that. Maybe CZ will fix that in the future too. But like most striker fire guns today, to take it apart, it's really easy. Just squeeze the trigger, pull the slide back slightly, push down the tabs. Comes apart. We'll try to give you a view inside here. It looks really similar to every other striker fire gun you see. Of course, there's only so many ways to skin a cat when it comes to striker fire guns. Then we'll take out the barrel. There's your barrel. There's your spring inside the gun. You know, still very similar to all the other striker fire guns out there. Reassembly is just as easy. Everything lined up here. Maybe I can put it back together. There we go. Voila, back together. And we'll show you this trigger pull on it. So here's our pull. You can see where that trigger safety catches right there. It's really kind of annoying. But there's the brake. And there's reset. You see how short that is. I mean, that's a really good reset. So there you go, a good overview of it. One thing, it does have night sights. They're not tritium sights. They're the charge in the daylight, and they'll glow for a little while in the dark, and then they're done. So if you want to have a true night sight, you're gonna have to change those out for a tritium night sight. Here's the magazine. 15 rounds as per usual. One thing I do like about it, you do have interchangeable back straps, and this gun does feel really good in your hand. It's going to really push your hand up into the beaver tail there and really get you a nice grip on this gun. So I really like the way it feels in my hand. Haven't shot it yet, so we'll find out if we like it after we shoot it. So we'll go set up our target, get everything ready, put some rounds down range, and see what we think. All right guys, we're about 15 yards from the target. We're gonna take a few shots and see what we think about it, and we'll go look at the target. Alrighty, those first three, we'll go down there and look at it and talk about it a little bit. All right, so first three shots, pretty good. I pulled the last one. So we'll talk about the first two. You can see they're pretty close at 15 yards. I was aiming right at the C, so sights are off just a little bit. No big deal though. But yeah, pretty impressive group. And actually I'm surprised at how well it shoots first couple rounds. Muzzle flips really low. Which is something else really nice. Nobody arcs a gun that has a lot of muzzle flip, and this one is exceptionally low for most handguns, even in 9mm. So we'll step back and take a few more shots with it, and come back and look at the target again. Okay, we're going to take a few more shots with this gun, and we'll go down range and look at the target. Probably do a couple of slow shots, and then we'll do a little bit of rapid fire. Alrighty, let's go look at it. Okay guys, so the first group, the slower group, we shot over here. I have one up here, I don't even know how that got there, but anyway. Really good group right here, shot well. Rapid fire, I came up to this corner right here, it did pretty good. I was still able to hold a fairly consistent and tight group. I fired a few down here too. Again, still a pretty consistent group. Pistol shoots well. I really don't like that trigger safety catching on it though. That really takes away from it. That is my chief complaint with this firearm, is that trigger safety is really terrible. If we can get that fixed, then you know I'd really enjoy this pistol. Because it really detracts from the trigger, and once you get past it though, the trigger's great. If this were my pistol, I'd probably remove it or try and find some kind of aftermarket solution for that. Other than that, muzzle flip is great on this pistol. Groups are great. Trigger's great, minus that trigger safety. Easy to disassemble. CZ's got a real winner on their hand, to be expected. CZ's always manufactured very, very good firearms. So if you haven't seen one of these guns, if your local shop's got one, definitely go by and check it out and see what you think about it. If you're in the market for a new pistol, this would be pretty high on my list of pistols to get, because it is a really good pistol. Not exactly sure on pricing, so I'm not going to say anything about that. I don't remember what they cost or what they're supposed to retail for right now. They do make several different variants of this gun. I think there's at least four different variants of it. One of them is threaded barrel, so if you have a suppressor or you are intending to get a suppressor in the future, CZ's got you covered. And I think they even make an FDE model now. So definitely check out the CZ P10. There we go. Now I can spit it out. Really great pistol. A couple revisions from now, they'll probably... this pistol can do nothing but get better. So there it is. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and we'll catch you next time. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe, and don't forget to go see Brian Hogan's page at Log Hollow Hydrographics. And again, thank you, Brian, for letting us borrow your pistol and coming out here to shoot it and see what we think about it. All right, thanks, guys.